Hello, hello, hello. Hi, Miss Wanda. Hi, Elizabeth. Hello, Miriam. Hi, Miss Beth. Hi, Trina. Thank you. Troy is getting into all kind of stuff over there. Troy. Your friend say hi. Oh, Lord, he is all into all kind of stuff. Hi, Kathy. Hi, Sue. How's everyone doing on this Wednesday? What's going on? Kathy, do you have a live today? Troy, he is looking for something. He's very intent on looking in his box for something. So he's not even bothering with me right now. Oh, Lord, there's stuff going to go everywhere. I can see it already. Hi, Sheila. Hi, Sue. Trina, what's going on? Is something up with your daughter? I hope everything's okay. Oh, my goodness. So today has been a really strange day for me. I've had anxiety all day today, and I don't know why. Have you guys ever had one of those days where you just have annoying anxiety and you don't know it's where it's coming from or why? Elizabeth says, hi, Troy. He's like this, literally. Hi, Jamie. So I've been looking forward to today's live because I can focus on something and hopefully get this weird yuckiness to leave me, because I mean, I'm not doing anything eventful or exciting or anything like that. So I don't know where the anxiety came from. I did have coffee on an empty stomach this morning, so I'm thinking that's probably the culprit. But I hate that feeling. I hate it. Yeah, you guys do it too. Hi, Lynn. How's Holly girl? No, I'm going to watch my granddaughter receive her black belt. Whoa! Awesome. That's awesome. Well, congratulations to your granddaughter. All righty, y'all. So, today... I hate when it does that. It makes it little like that. Today we are going to be able to get this finished up. So, like I said, I didn't torture you all with the painting of all of the molds. I will tell you though, Sue, that out of sorts feeling, like you don't know what's going on, like, but you know, you got the nervous jitters, and I hate it when I have anxiety like that. Yeah, I know. It's not a good combo. I know, Miriam. It's not. So I went ahead and I did have to cut back some of the mold. Oh, I got distracted. Hi, Gabby. You're up late again. All of the links for all of the projects, all of the products that I've used up until Monday are in the description. So all the molds, the hot air balloon, all of that is in the description of this video. So if you're looking for anything, I did remember to put it all in there. So the balloon's in there. This mold is in there. This mold is in there. It's all there. I got that just before my live Tuesday. Yeah, I don't know. And again, like, nothing's going on. You know what I mean? So I don't know where it came from. I'm pretty sure it's the coffee. All right. So I did go ahead and paint all of the molds. I dry brushed it with the Mandel color. And I did have to cut back. I did cut back the mold a little bit. That's why it's not, you know, finished, like painted there, because we're going to have to, in order for it to sit flush, I did pull off that bottom piece. I also did drill a small hole so the chain can go through there, which... Yeah, I did notice that. Wait, I missed. What's going on with my daughter? Was rushed to the hospital yesterday. She's doing okay. Hope it's not to have surgery. She has a stone lodged. Oh, goodness. Oh, my goodness. That's not fun. I know. I had a roommate that woke me up in the middle of the night. Hi, Rima. Hi, Brioni. Thank you. Thank you for joining us. I had a roommate that woke me up in the middle of the night, just buckled over on the couch, yelling because she was in pain. And I didn't know what was going on. And yeah, she had a gallstone. All right. So this hole did go through until I painted it. So I might have to go this way. I don't remember which way I went. But yeah, she scared the heck out of me. It was in the middle of the night and she was hooting and hollering. And I thought somebody had broken in or something was happening with her. All right, we might have to get the drill back out and open this hole because I'm pretty sure what's in there is the paint because the hole went through. Prior to me painting. Hi, Nicole. Thank you, Beth. Yeah, so when she had to go in for emergency surgery. Yep. All right, let me grab my drill really quickly. It's just right here. So, and then we'll open up this hole. Like I said, the hole was open, but then when I paint, you know, paint probably dripped down in there. So we're going to go through and put the chain through it. And then we're also going to put the chains. We're going to droop the chains on the balloon and then fix the basket, right? All right, let's open this back up a little bit. All right, now let's see if we got that paint dislodged out of there. She's still recovering from surgery she has. Oh my goodness, Trina. Well, she'll be definitely thinking about her, hoping. See, now how did I know that this was going to be, that this was going to happen live, on the live, right? So I tested this before I painted it. So, and now it's going to give me problems. Power tools, which Nicole is not allowed to use. All right. I'm trying to see where it's getting hung up on. Because it's getting hung up somewhere. And I don't want to make that hole too big. Because then it will really... I'm afraid because it's so thin up there that it's going to break the tip. See, I can see it coming through. It's right there, but it won't. It's not coming all the way through. Yep. Oh, there. Look. Oh, there it goes. See, it's trying to make a liar out of me now. But it's still not free. There we go. Now I don't trust it. So now I'm just going to pull a bunch of chain and cut it. All right. Because I know as soon as I take that back out, I won't get it back through. So we will actually have to make a loop and then we'll do an eyelet on there or we'll put something on there so it doesn't go through anymore. All right. Let me lock that. So Troy doesn't like drill a hole through onyx or something. Of course. Of course, of course. I love power tools. All right. So what I was thinking is I did pull out, so you guys can see, I moved my camera a little bit too, so this is going to throw me off a little bit. Oh, I got scoot, 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 scoot. Hey, I'm pretty good with the grill. Uh-huh. Sure. So what I was thinking about is here, what do you guys think about if we put some gems on here? Just so that, because see now there's blue on the horses, but this is going to be down at the basket, right? So on this, it's pretty, it's, you know, it's pretty, but it's plain as far as color. Look at, can you tell my anxiety? Can you see my hands? Oh, I hate that. So I'm thinking that we put on some, a little bit of bling on here just to give it a little bit of color. So that way, well, yeah, you have to have gems. Hi, Miss Linda. So that way, you know, it ties in this blue down here. So let's get, I think I was looking and it was number 3, I think. Let's look at it. Maybe not. Maybe that's too green. I don't know if you guys can tell. I think that's maybe too green. Let's go with something a little bit bluer. Let me turn this on over here too. All right. We'll bring this over here. Deep breaths and drink some water. Yeah, you know, as soon as the, you know, the coffee, I do need to drink water, though, and get this, the coffee out of my system. I can't see you, baby. Where are you? Oh, I know. I seen what you did. You were going cuckoo, pulling things out. There we go. Let's use this one. Oh, that's not the right color. Let me shake that. There you go. What do you guys think? Well, focus and look at my hands shaking like a dodo. Hi, Helen. I suffer with anxiety bad like that, Terry. It's part of the reason I don't go live as much. I'm praying for you. Oh, thank you. Yeah. For most part, it's controllable, you know, but there are some times where it just acts up. And I think, and then when you focus on it, because, you know, like me, right, I'm like, okay, I want this to go away, so I'm more focused on it, then it, you know, it's even more, acts up even more. Okay, so let's put some, I'm thinking, so we'll just put it, can you guys, all right, so I brought you in a little closer, so I'm thinking I'm just going to put it in the middle here. And then, like, on the three little parts there. Thank you, Lori. Hello. I know Justin's live right now, so I didn't think we'd have too many friends in here. So I appreciate you all for being here. All right. So these might be a little challenging only because it's kind of on a curved surface. So, because they have, you know, when you heat them up with the tool, see, that's going to be pretty. Do you want to come in closer or is that too close? Is that okay or is that too close? Yeah, it does. It amplifies it, right? I just turned this on. It might not be hot enough. We'll see. Whoa. Yeah. Hold on a minute, you guys. So when you shake, which you guys know, I don't usually have the shakes. So we might not even use the heat tool on this. If I'm shaking too much, I might just have to glue them on here with regular glue instead of using the tool. Oh, there we go. Thank you. Hi, Betty. How are you? Oh. Oh, I looked up. Hold on. Thank you, Betty. I will remove it right now. All right. Hold on. I moved that to look up to see what Betty was telling me to remove. And then I scratched that. So we're going to need to fix that. Hold on. Let me remove the ticker. Thank you very much, Betty. All right. There we go. All right. So I'm thinking that it's going to take too long for that little tool. So hold on, because now I need to get a little bit of the Mandel because I scratched it. Not even when making book nooks. I know, right? Troy, you got to turn that down, baby. Turn it down. Turn it down. Come on, son. I'm going to have to mute it. Gonna get my video muted with your is that Cardi B, Troy? All right, and then hold on. And obviously my OCD is a little bit up too. Godly, guys, I'm a mess today. Because I can't leave that alone with it scratched. I know, right? I didn't even have that much anxiety with the book nooks. All right, so I'm just going to take, actually, no, you know what? I have gym glue. So I'm going to use the Pentart gym glue. So there we go. And then we'll just get these put on quick, fast, and in a hurry instead of waiting for the little tool to heat up. Let's get the... What, Bubba's? I know, you can't listen to... You can't have the music on that loud, Pops. I haven't used this in a minute. Son, I can't see ya. You're gonna get Sue yelling at me thinking I'm ignoring you. I can't see you, babe. Thank you. Hi, good morning, Jesse. How are you? Oh, wrong thing. See you guys? I'm just out of it. All right, see, that's a lot quicker than us waiting to heat that up with the tool. There we go. See, and then it gives it a little bit of something that's up at the top, right? I just need to make sure I stay in frame. So, I'll do... couple of these. So, Jesse, are you actually at work right now, or are you on your way to work? Troy, see, I knew it. Troy, what do you need? He was trying to give me his phone so I could put it on the charger. I agree with you on the little piece in that light box. Oh, I know. I'm telling you, Trina. It's annoying. So, Trina, I sent Trina my old, my old softbox light, the big one, because I used to fight with it every day. So on Prime Day, because I have two of them, I got one like the one that doesn't give me problems. Well, I asked Trina, because she was looking for one, if she wanted to fight with it. I think now she's probably wishing that she's not fighting with it. Yeah, Trina, if you are able to keep it up and not have to take it down after each live, that's ideally what you want to do. But see, I can't do that. I can't keep it up because of, you know, Troy and the dogs. They're bound to knock it over. So having to fight with that thing constantly and get that little piece in there is a nightmare. Oh, you're getting ready for work. All right. Look it. Doesn't that look pretty? Oh. I got to be careful because you guys are zoomed in so far. let me just do this. So that way it's going to be, I don't know. I'm going to shake this up. It's like every now and again, a little clump will come out. What's happening? Gee, my knee. As if I don't have enough issues here, Jim Glue. Keep giving me problems, and I'm going to go to my express glue. So last night was such a nice evening. It cooled down so much last night. It was actually strange. So I'm hoping, yep, there's no glue there. I'm hoping that it cools down. It will stay up. I won't take it down. I thought about putting a dab of hot glue to make. Oh, no, Trina, don't do that. The hot glue and then the heat. You don't want to do that. Yeah, you don't want to put hot glue. Really? You got rain, Miriam? Holy guacamole. Is that the first time it's rain? I switched to the express glue, you guys, because I haven't used this in so long. I think it really needs to have, needs to be shaken. And I'm just, I'm not trying to do all that right now. Now you do, you know, the glue will dry transparent. So I'm not worried about the white that you can see. Once it's all dry, you won't see it. Oh, grabbed the wrong one. Yeah, I don't know. Last night, it was like, it was cooler outside than it was in the house. And and it was pretty cool in the house because, I mean, obviously the AC is running all day long. Good golly, Miss Molly. But, yeah, I was really surprised because I opened the door to take the trash out back. And I went, whoa, shoot, we need to turn off the AC and open the windows. So, and then even like this morning, because typically, right, you know, as soon as the sun comes up, it's hot as heck. First time in a while that it rained more than an hour, but we've had rain like it would rain. Oh, that's right. I remember you had said that it was like kind of like a teasing. Wow. I don't know. Maybe this extreme heat wave warning will relax now. Because right now, at least on my computer, right now, and it's 130, 124, it says that it's 82 degrees outside. So that's, I mean, I'll take that any day over what we have been dealing with. We have a thunder and lightning storm here right now, but I'm positive rain. Oh, wow. Yeah, so Trina, weren't you saying like you were having power issues the other day, right? I thought maybe you were saying you were going in and out or something because of your power. All right, so that's it. So I'll bring you guys back up so you're not all up in here. But see, so now we have just a little bit of something, something at the top. And look at that. See? I think that looks really good. So I'm going to set this aside and then let this dry. And then we'll start working on the balloon. All right. So, hi, Kelly Cat. Okay. Whoa. I must not have brought you guys out all the way. There you go. Okay. So once that top dries, what I'm going to do is I'll end up snipping that and then we'll mess with getting that flush on top of there. So let me put these gems away and then we'll get, because I also have to snip these and I want to put the chain on these as well. So we'll anchor the basket in there, and then we'll figure out how how we're going to anchor those chains in there. Cause I might end up having just to like drill little holes in there, sticking some hot glue down in there and then putting the chain down, but we'll see. We will see. All right. It's strange. Usually around this time of summer, it would get hot till 12 to 1, then it would rain all day. Oh, wow. Oh man, Betty, 104, no rain in sight. Yipes. Yep, see, that's what we've been dealing with here. But, hey, I'm not complaining. If it'll cool down just a little bit, I'm all good. I also have these. I don't know, though. I was thinking maybe, because this has like a, it's got that gold blue color. Oh, all you guys are picking up is the gold, but it actually does have the blue. So I don't know. I might hang that with the basket as, but we'll see. All right. So now what I want to do with the chain, where's the chain here? All right. Let's get the glue on. Oh, let's turn this other gun off and get this one on. All right. So now one thing that I'm not worried about is, because obviously it's going to look like there's just chain, you know, starting from nowhere. Hi, Rennie. How are you? So I want to go like this, right? With the silver, and then we'll do the gold from the ones that we skipped. So let's see how long we want this so we can cut a few of them. Can you drill holes on opposite sides to feed the chain for the basket? In the rope mold, Miss Linda? What do you guys think about like that? Or should it be less? I know it's not hanging right now. Hold on. Let me stand it up and then hang it. Do you think that's okay? Should it be that length? Not less. All right. So let's, what pops? So let's cut a few of these. What pops? Oh, your phone. Yeah, because you gave it to me. Come on, now you're gonna get me in trouble. Oh, where is this coming from? That's good. Okay, so now let's cut a couple of these. Turn it on. You have to turn it on, pops. You turned it off. Not me. Don't blame me. I didn't do it. All right, so now let's just cut a couple of these so we can hang these. And then we'll cut a couple of the golds as well. Oh, your watch. Yeah. I'm telling you, you're going to get me in trouble. Miss Sue's going to think I'm ignoring you. For anybody who's new, that voice that you hear is my son, Troy. So he's given me a piece of his mind right now because he wants his watch on, but he's across to the other side of the room. I think actually I cut that a little bit long. So this chain is just regular jewelry chain, you guys. It's nothing special. You can get it on Amazon if you want me to put that link in there. I think I have one time already from when I was doing, I don't know, the eyelets. No, where you have the four separate ropes connect to the basket so you don't have to try to glue a chain inside the balloon. Possibly. Hi, LaMaya. Hi, Carol. Yeah, possibly, Miss Linda. That might be easier. See, the thing I'm looking at, though, is the holes are already, because I got to do something. I either have to push through the rope that's already there into the hole, so there already be a hole there. So if we go one, we're going to go one, that one to that one, that one to that one, that one to that one. That's one, one, two, three, four, five, six, right? So how many do we have here? We have one, two, three, four. Let's cut two more and then we'll get the gold. Hi, Gwen. How are you? All right, so let's cut two more of these. And then we'll get gold so we can do the gold as well. Oh, you know what I should have did? I should have made that hole bigger at the top. So that way I could have put the gold and the silver at the top of the, where we're going to put the top on the balloon. I go on the top. All right, so now we're going to need a gold. I don't know why I didn't pull out the gold already. All right. Oh, that's why I didn't pull out this gold, because I don't think there's going to be enough. So I have a new, because you guys know I do backups on top of backups. Hi, Robbie. So this is how it comes, you guys, and you can get it in different, you know, different lengths. So, oh, of course, I opened the wrong side. The gold is on this side. All right, so now let's get, because I have a feeling that gold is not going to be enough. Because you don't get very, you know, you get, I think it says like 60 feet or something like that, but who knows. Hi, Kathy. Hi, Miss Edie. All right, so now I'm going to cut these the same length. And do we like this? I think it only has the one gold. Yep, so it's going to be this bright gold. I guess that's fine. And then, like I said before, if we wanted to hang any charms or anything from it, we could. We just have to see and make sure it, you know, doesn't look out of sorts. Whoa. All right. How is everyone today? Hump day. See you guys? I get my brain focusing and I feel better already. Feel better already. My hands probably aren't as shaky as they were when we first started either. All right, see, I'm out of this chain. Let's see if it's gonna, see if it's too short. Probably, right? Oh my gosh, just a little too short. All right, so let's save that though. So how many do we have here? We have one, two, three, four. So we need two more. Where did you get the change from? This is good. Thank you, Robbie. I just got it from Amazon. I can put the link in the description. I'm sorry. I don't know why I didn't think to put that down there. Put everything else down there. Of course, you know I'm going to forget something. All right, so let's cut two more of this. One. And then what I'm thinking is we can put some flat back pearls on where these are starting. I'll show you what I mean. All right. I think that one probably goes there. Let me hang these off to the side. Let me grab something really quick. Oh, so what I'm thinking is I have flat back pearls in all different colors. We have gold and all different sizes. So we have the gold where we could do the golds. And then I have this color silver and a darker silver, but I think that one would probably be better. I don't know. Let's see. And I'm probably going to knock over a box light, so you guys hear me yell. Oh, maybe that silver is better. All right, so we have all the sizes of flat backs in gold and silver. Can you see the chain link in FB? Oh, yes, I can. I was hoping you hadn't said while my company was needing help. I'm hoping. Oh, Sue is putting the links as usual. My Sue, she's amazing. So we'll use some flatbacks. So what I'm saying is, I don't know what size we'll want. I don't think we want to go too tiny. So what we'll do is, so we don't have the chain just like sitting there, right? So what I'm thinking is we're going to have the chain drooping like this, and then we'll have a flat back, which you know doggone well, I can't pick it up with my finger. We'll have a flat back pearl on each side of it. Do you guys have these problems with your pickers, with your gem pickers? It's not like I'm jabbing into the gems or anything, but I find that these break, and I always keep mine in my container. But this always, I know it's just like a wax, but it always breaks. Hi, Teresa Cherry. How are you? All right. So I just put a new wax on there. Okay. So if we're having this on the balloon like this, can you see that? So then what I want to do with the flat back is to have it coming out of, or have the flat back on top of the chain. You've never used that one? Like so. See what I mean? All right, so let's get these put on. I'm running out of room, but that's nothing new. All right, let's put these over here and move this back into frame. Okay, so now I want one there. Are you guys still in frame with me? I will go. Probably right about there. And I'll put it in the crease there. The people. What? What did I miss? Okay, so I'm just going to use a little bit of the hot glue. And yes, before anybody yells at me, I will grab a finger so that I don't burn myself. So if I put that in the groove, if I put that in the rope groove, it won't stick up as high. So I have my glue fingers. So before anybody starts screaming at me and I'm going to burn myself, I'll put my fingers on. I'm laughing like a fool. Hi, Kimberly. Why? What happened? All right. So then let's see if we can. We're going to get this kind of in the right area here. All right. So let's go with right there. I'm trying not to squeeze the life out of the glue gun. And then I'll push that down with both. All right. So now, can you guys see? I know because it's laying, it doesn't look right, but that's, or ruin your nails. Oh, I don't, you know. You guys notice I popped all my nails off the acrylics. These are all my nails. This one bent all the way backwards yesterday, which felt oh so fun. But yeah, I can only do acrylics for so long and then they get in my way. All right, so now let's do that one right there as well. I might as well just put this in the because it's just the chain, and then we'll also make sure to reinforce it by putting the flat back on there. Oh, too far down. You got to move up a little bit. So I've had a lot of people ask me where I've gotten the balloon and where I've gotten the mold from. So if you guys are going to do this or anything with I would love to see it. I haven't talked about it in quite a long time, but we do have a group. So if you want to share it in our group, that would be awesome. All right. So this is a little bit too long, you guys. So I'm going to glue it where it's supposed to be, which is right there, and cut off the rest. Yeah, and I'm not an affiliate with the factory, Direct Crafts. So if you guys find it cheaper somewhere else, by all means. But I have never seen the this size balloon anywhere else, so... But yeah, if you guys are not a part of our group, I'm sure Sue will grab the link. Please share it in there or tag me. I would love to see if you guys do it. Thank you, Miss Linda. All right. So, yes, I'm not quite done shaking because I can feel it a little bit, but it's gone away for the most part. I'm going to give it a go. Oh, yay, Brioni, I can't wait to see it. Please tag me. I mean, if you do it like this or however you know, put your spin on it, I would love to see it. Okay, I'm just going to hold it up a little bit because I can see some of these were cut a little bit longer, which is fine. I'd rather it be cut longer than shorter. Hold on. Am I in the... Yeah, I am. And I'm literally just using a dot of the hot glue because I don't want a whole bunch there. Oh, how cute! Can you guys see that? Yay! And then I'm going to cut off the extra here. Okay. And then any of the glue strings that I have on here from the hot glue, I'm not worried about. I will hit it with the dryer and then they'll go away. All right, so now let's, actually this can probably be cut one or more link off. There we go. I forgot to add the eyelashes on my mask I made for the D. Oh, add them and then just repost it, Trina. What am I looking for? I just did a search. I can get one here from Spotlight, a store just down the road. Oh, how cool! All right, thank you, Miss Edie. All right, so let's put a little dab here again. And I want to hold it up to keep checking how long it's drooping. I doubt that I cut them all too long. I just didn't take into account how much I would be gluing on each side. Yes, son? Yes. Oh, did you find me again? Just don't turn up the sound too loud, okay, babe? All right, so push that down. Oh, I like it, you guys. Look. As if the little screen is better for you guys to see than the big screen. Carol says, hi, Georgia. Oh, you turned the internet off again. You need to come here so I can turn it back on for you. You turned it off. Why are you laughing? Did you do it on purpose? You little sneaky, sneaky. All right. There you go. Hurry, I just put hot glue. It'll come, you got to give it a minute to connect. That's all right, son. I'm going to have to clean it up after. All right, and then let's do this side. I keep having to hold it up just a little bit to see where the chain is hanging to make sure it's, you know, all hanging kind of at the same length. It's going to be crazy looking if it's all dilapidated. Yeah, he does. He has that smirk on his face like, you always fall for it, Mom. Like, I really don't need your help. But it's fun just messing with you. There we go. Okay. That's my Troy boy. He likes messing with me. All right, and then we should have. Oh, is that going too high? Hold on. Why is it like that? Hold on, you guys. It looks like it got higher, or this one's really low now. Because when I go to string this one, it's really low. So I must have got higher somewhere. So hold on. Because you see how high that one is compared to this one? So I'm going to have to work my way back the other way to see where it got higher at. And as a note, instead of just going one way, just like when you're, I know better than that. Well, like when you're drawing a circle, you should go left, right, left, right. So that way you meet in the middle. Because you won't go at the same angle, right? You're going to, your angle is going to change if you're just going all the way. If you're just going left, you know what I'm saying? All right, let me. So that needs to be right here. And then I need to move the other one down and find out where it got messed up at. All right, so now Hold on, I need to hold it up for a minute. Oh, it's these two right here. All right. It's the last two that I put on. I went real high. So let me move that down. And it's in my lap. I'm still here. I've got to use my legs to hold this. Hold on. Wait a minute. All right. Let's get this one. And then glue this on. You went too high on one spot and then high for the rest, so the wire was not too long. Yeah, exactly. All right. Okay. So now what I want to do is do the gold from the opposite ones. So where we have the silver, now I want to do the gold on the ones that we didn't do. Does that make sense? So like that. Yeah. Yeah. Lap crafting. Because, you know, you need a third hand, right? And so sometimes that third hand ends up being like your legs, squeezing it together. Okay. And then we'll go this way. Drop that in there. Oh, yeah. I like that. I like that a lot. See? You have to. Telling you, if anybody ever invents like a something, like you know how the booms are? Somebody would invent like a third hand. And then let's turn it a little bit this way. And that's going to be right there. Aw, oh, it's so pretty. The gold over the paper looks really pretty, right? Hi, Pamela. How are you? Okay, so then let's go. Well, I'll go this way for right now. And then I'll come back to the other way. I have a little book box between my knees. Hold on. To heavy body gel, I'm lazy to get up. Seriously, though, it's like, man. All right, and then, so then this one, the gold isn't as hard because I can kind, you know, I can see where the other ones are, but I'm going to have to adjust the silver. Right? Because see, look, I can see right here is where it got real high. You see it? So it needs to come down. It needs to come down. So let's... But, hold on, I'm not going to mess with it right now because I'm going to have to recut the silver because I did cut off some of the links because I thought I cut it too long. But it wasn't that I cut it too long. I was too high where the width wasn't. No. Oh, no, don't go up there. You're going to get stuck in the glue. So I'll have to recut some of the silver and then adjust it. But I won't do that just right now because if I do that right now, I'm going to pull off some paint. Yep. See? What a dodo bird. All right. So then let's turn this a little bit. So that needs to come down here and not be so high like the other ones. Hi, Tina. A swivel skyhook. Anything that could be used as a third hand would be amazing. Oh my gosh, I really like that. Okay, so I know that this is too high. And these are too high. We're going to need to recut. Actually, hold on. I have to stop. Because, oh, did I have an extra? Hold on. Because if I don't stop and cut the same length in the silver, it's going to be, okay. I guess I cut 7. So that's fine. I don't have to stop. Whoa. Yes. Again, I haven't mentioned this in a while. I used to say it all the time. I do stream on 3 different places. I stream on my Facebook, Terry Lightsey. My other page, which is Terry's Crafty Creations, which I'm not on there very often. And also YouTube. So if you are if you're commenting and you're wondering why I'm talking to some individuals and you don't see the comments, it's because it's probably coming across on another platform. If you are on Terry's Crafty Creations, you might want to go over to just the regular Terry Lightsey page just because that's where most people go. The only reason why I still... am on that channel is because I can't get Facebook to help me change my, wow, it's going to happen again. Hold on. I can't get Facebook to change my Terry Lightsey account to a regular business account. It's a mess. It's really crazy. All right, hold on. I don't want it to get combobulated again. Okay. So for right now, I'm going to stop right there because I have to fix these silver chains in the back. So that's how it's going to look, though. I'm not going to torture you guys with pulling off those silver chains and adjusting it because I've got to paint when I pull them off. All right, so let me hit the strands with the heat gun. Okay, so now what I was talking about before is So how we can see that we have all these glue pieces there, what I want to do is take some of the flatbacks. I have two colors of the silver. You guys can tell me which ones. I'll show you the really big one so you can see the color properly instead of like the itty bitty. So here is a silver. It's that color. And then I have a lighter. Again, I'm showing you the big size so that way you can actually see it instead of the itty bitty. Or this one that's a little bit lighter. But it is silver because I have white and that's not the white. So I don't know. Do you guys think we should go with the darker or the lighter one? I'm thinking maybe the darker one because it's closer to the chain. I think. All right, let me get these golds because the darker, yeah, okay. All right, now we just need to find the proper size because obviously that's ginormous. There goes my nose running on cue. This size is probably going to be good enough. I knew it was going to fall. Hey, come back. All right, let's see. Ah! All right, so if they hang this way, trying to get it to hang nicely, and then let's get this back. I think I like that size. Just quit standing up. It makes your nose run. Is that what happens? I'm going to have to watch replay when my granddaughter wants me in. Oh, your grand. Oh, okay. Have fun in the pool. So if gravity would, when gravity is right, that's how it would look. Yeah. If I would quit doing funny shaped projects, Sue, it would help. Whoops. Do I want to use? Yeah, I'll probably use hot glue. It's this doggone long glue stick that's making that fall. All right, let's see if I need this to pick up. So that way, because every time I try to grab it, it wants to fall. So let's use this one instead. Of course, it's not long enough, or what's happening? I'm telling you guys, it's just one of those days. It is just one of those days. All right, let's try this again. Maybe it is when I stand up. I don't know. I just know that every time I start a live, I don't have a runny nose. And then all of a sudden, it'll be runny. It's quite annoying. So then you can't see the start and stops of the chain, and it looks more. And then this one. She's probably on Justin's channel right now. That's probably why she's not here. Because I seen that he had just popped on just a few minutes before I had popped on. All right. So now if I hold it up, let's do this. So if I hold it up, that's what it's supposed to look like, right? Can't see where I'm going. Left, right. So once I get these even here in the back and pull that off, that's what that's going to look like. So yeah, I like it. I like it. Will it just put me? Of course it wouldn't. All right. Thank you. Okay, I got to find out. Can I keep on? Yeah, I can do one more silver here because those are right. It's the other ones that are going to bounce up and go too high after that. So this is just another picker pin. If you guys have ever seen it, picker pencil, you sharpen it. But with this, I can actually go like that and get the wax so that these bigger ones stay. Because sometimes with the picker pin that I just showed you that I've been using, that doesn't grab. It doesn't stay on that tip. Adjust that a little bit. And then I can do one more gold. And then I have to stop because I've got to adjust them in the back. And I'm not going to torture you guys doing that because that's just craziness. All right. Aw, so pretty. I like it. I like it. By golly, George. All right. So, again, I'll pull the silver off after I get off of here. I'll pull the silver off, and then I'll adjust the gold so that the gold's on top of it, so it's all the same. Jamie! All right, so now for this, what I want to do with this is I'm just going to loop it. And so it doesn't fall back through that little hole. Not that it's going to fall back through since it was hard enough to get it even in there. Thank you. Yeah, I can heat it up and then I can take it off and then it won't. It'll pull off some of the paint, but it won't pull off as much as me just yanking on it right now. All right. So now let's get, so this is just all of the size of the, I just want a smaller. Let's see if we can get, this might be too difficult for me to see. Look at that. How small that is. Ridiculous. Yes, I am going to put my readers on because I cannot see that small. You know it will fall back through if you don't do anything. Yeah, I know. Just like when I tested it yesterday, I was like, oh, that's great. It's open. And then, you know, you get on a live and it's like, yeah, no. All right, so let's make this, let's pull this. All right, let's do it on this side first.
Where's my other?
So I'm just going to put this through here and all right, that should probably be good. Of course, you know. Ah! Hold on. I want it right there. I knew it wasn't going to be that easy. Let's start with it on this end first. How are you, Jamie? Jamie, are you doing live still at your at the time you used to go live? Am I missing it? Because I haven't caught any of your lives since you've done the second page. Really, guys? There we go. Let's put it in there. All right. Whoa. So now we have a loop there, right? But we have to do it on the bottom as well because it's going to come through the bottom. And then on the bottom, I'm just going to grab a bigger one. And then I'll glue it. If this one even fits in the chain, because, oh, nope, it didn't. Because the gauge of this one might be too small. I mean, the gauge of the chain might be too small for this one. It is. All right. We're going to try to go as big as we can as soon as we can fit it in the chain because that's what we'll use to glue it to anchor it. Yeah, I don't think this one's going to fit in there either. Shame on me. Because remember, this is going to glue down to the balloon, so it's not necessarily going to, it's not going to show, but it will pull right through if I don't put something down. There we go. Okay, so now it doesn't pull through. So now I can actually snip this off and then just throw some hot glue on here, flattened. If that makes sense. Or are you guys like, what the heck are you doing? All right. So now I'm just gonna flatten that. All right. All right. So now we have a little, ooh, I can't see. So now we have our little top. Can you use Wi-Fi? Wait, what? I need to get 100 feet Ethernet cable and a route. Oh, is that? So I'm not missing you. Okay. Man. It's always something, huh? Everything's, oh, it never can be easy. Okay, so now this. So now I'm going to go ahead and snip off that. And if that can go through. Actually, I'll just leave it because then nothing's going to be moving around in there. So now this is going to go on to here. Now what I want to see is, see how there's, it's still lifted a little bit. I don't particularly like that. I would rather it be flush. So in order for it to be flush, I'm going to have to cut back the tops of this a little bit more. Oh, it's, of course it would be on the opposite side of the house. All right, so now. I'm just taking a sharp blade, and I did change the blade right before we got on because I knew that I was going to have to cut this back. Just be careful that you don't jab it through because it is paper mache after all. You don't want a big hole in your balloon. I know, I can't wait till you start going live again, Jamie. I'll worry about the ends of these and making it all pretty as long as soon as I make sure that we've cut back enough. All right, so that's good on this side. So these here are too long. Me? Why, Miss Wanda? I'm not too accident prone. I haven't drawn blood yet on a live. Not to say that I won't, but you know. I'm actually not cutting. That's why it's taken me a little bit because I'm just kind of wiggling the blade in there. All right. Now let's just make sure all of this is out of the way. Now let's check and see. All right, see, that's much, it's sitting, I don't know, can you see? It's sitting a lot better now. All right. Let's clean up the tops of this and then we'll paint that blue and then we can stick on the top. Again, it doesn't have to be, you know, because it's underneath. So, palm of her hand and cut muscle in half on Sunday. So, oh my gosh, Miss Wanda. Good lordy be. Holy smokes. What was she doing? Was she opening something or? All right, so I'm actually going to just dip in the lids. Because it's only right here that I'm trying to paint without getting it all on there. You won't even see this, but just in case a little bit peeks through, at least it'll be the same color. All right. Hi, Robin. How are you? Okay, let's glue that a little bit. And then dry that a little bit, glue it. Okay. Have a good day, Kathy. Thanks for being here. Cutting corn with brand new knife. Oh, heck. Yikes. Good grief. Oh. That just gives me the heebie-jeebies just thinking about that. Oh, goodness gracious. Golly, Miss Wanda. Ah! That gives me the willies. Because I've cut myself like that before. Bleh. You know the, like, the Pampered Chef, like, the graters? I was going down and it wasn't like level where the knife was. And so I put my finger, this finger, and it just sliced the whole tip. And yeah, it was not fun at all. All right. So now I am going to get some heavy body gel and I'm going to stick that at the top. So I'm going to use some of the heavy body gel, Pentart, the glossy. And before I do this, though, I'm just going to take my Dremel really quickly. And right where this ridge is from where I pulled that off, I'm just going to sand that down a little bit. Because if I don't, I'm going to get that uneven. Only that's going to be what's trying to stick instead of it being flush. And then I'm just going to do a rough sanding on all of this where I'm going to put the glue. All right. Where's my... Oh, I bet, Miss Wanda. I bet. I couldn't even imagine like that. Again, just you saying what happened gives me the heebie-jeebies. Okay, so now I'm just going to get my palette knife and then put heavy body gel on this. All right, now I've got to stand this up so I can see where it's going. You guys see? So cute! All right. I'm just going to hold it for a minute just for it to make contact there because heavy body gel just takes a minute. So cute! And I see the time. So what I'm going to do is I will stick the I'll stick the bottom half of the carousel on this so you guys can see. Because we're not going to do this again on Friday. I will finish this up tonight and post pictures tomorrow. So then this is going to sit in here like so. Right? You guys can even see it, but I'll show you in just a second. Thank you. I put a lot of heavy body gel on there, so it's going to take a minute. I'm not going to be able to hold it by the top. That's for doggone sure. Not right now. To show you. Okay, so let me show you guys. So all I'm going to do tonight, can you see? What is that? Oh, it's the camera. I told you guys I moved my camera. That was weird. Anyhow, so it's hard for you guys to see the whole thing, but so this is what you'll see. I'm going to fix those chains, and then the heavy body gel will dry, and then that will be the bottom. All I'm going to do with this here is change the chain. So I'm going to cut the rope and then attach the chain. And I think I'll do the same thing. I'll put the little flat backs there as well. Because, I mean, right now as it is, the rope is just coming out of nowhere. So I'll put flat backs where I put the chains there as well. And then we're good to go. So now all I got to do is figure out how to take pictures of this again. It's going to be like that big mannequin trying to figure out how to take pictures of it free hanging from somewhere. I'm like thinking maybe I'll hang it from the ceiling fan and take pictures of it in the air. I did put all of that stuff is in the description. So the mold, all of the molds, the rope mold, this, the horse carousel. And then anything else that I use, the only thing that's not in there is the flat backs and the chains, but the chain Sue put in there. Hi, Wayne. So, yeah, so that's the only difference that you guys will see will be this will be the chain, and then I will fix the back and put the flat backs on the back. So I'll take pictures of it and I will post it probably later on today or tomorrow. It'll probably have to wait for all for the heavy body gel to dry, because the heavy body gel's got to dry on this too. So anyhow, can you put that white pencil in the link? This one? Sure. I can do that, Lynn. I think that's it. It's just the chain. I'll put the pencil in there and the flat backs just in case. So anyhow, thank you guys as always for being here. I feel better already compared to like, see, look, I'm pretty stable now. I'm not. Ooh. So anyhow. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I will talk to you on Friday. Don't forget, on Friday, we're going to do two drawings. We're going to do for the Crafting Chaos 50, and then we'll do the regular Happy Mail giveaway. Jesse, you have a great rest of your day. Everyone else, have a great rest of your evening, and I'll talk to you on Friday. Talk to you later.